Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER. Today I want to talk to you about JFlash, our flash programming software. JFlash allows you to program internal and external flash memory on your embedded system using either a SEGGER Flasher programmer or a SEGGER J-Link debug probe. JFlash supports programming the internal flash of most popular MCUs, but it also supports programming of the external serial or parallel NOR flash that might be connected to that MCU. You can run JFlash on Windows, macOS, or Linux, and you can control it either via GUI or via command line, which means you can also use it for production purposes. JFlash is part of the J-Link software pack that you can download from the SEGGER website right here. On the JFlash landing page, you can find some performance numbers for programming internal flash, as well as some external QSPI flash. You can also find some information on multibank support, as well as support for various other flash types. So let's look at my demo system over here. On the left, I have JFlash open with a particular project. And on the right, you can see the programmer and the target board that's on my desk. This is a SEGGER Flasher Compact. And this is a SEGGER Empower board with a Cortex M4 device on it. So what I want to do is program this target board with JFlash. So here in the project information window, you have some general information about the project, like the name, how your programmer is connected, the target interface, which target MCU you are programming. On the right here is the window for the data file. So that is essentially the hex file or the binary file that came out of the build process and that you want to program into your target. And then down here we have a log window where JFlash gives you information about what's going on. Before you do the programming, you want to make sure that your project settings are correct. So here in the project settings, you can double check how your programmer is connected to your host PC. Could be via USB or TCP/IP. Double check the target interface, the MCU that you're programming, including any specific target options you might need. This dialog shows an overview of the flash memory that's going to be programmed. And this is an important tab, which is the production tab, where you tell JFlash whether you want to power your target board through the flasher or J-Link device, or if you're powering it separately, if you want to program any serial numbers, and what the production programming actions should be after the process gets started. And the last tab has some settings that can influence the time it'll take you to program your target. And once your settings look good, you can go to Target, Production Programming, and JFlash will connect to the Flasher Compact, and together they will program the target MCU and then restart the application afterwards. So you can see this just took under 8 seconds, and it was about 600 kilobytes of memory that was programmed. So you can program your target in this PC-based mode, or the other option you have is download the configuration and the data file to the actual Flasher unit with this option here. So now the configuration and the data file are downloaded to the Flasher. They're actually stored on the device now. And now what you can do is also just hit the programming button and Flasher Compact or any other Flasher unit will be able to program the target microcontroller in standalone mode. Of course, the other option you have is to get yourself a Flasher hub and hook up your Flasher compacts to that, and then you have true gang programming. One last look here onto the JFlash landing page, where you can also find a list of supported NOR flashes. So here you can see which external NOR flashes are supported. And as you can see, there are quite a few. So in a nutshell, this is what I wanted to let you know about JFlash. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out our other videos on SEGGER software and tools. And thanks for watching.